kings. You are not our queens. You are not our gods. We are not your property. We do not acquiesce to your criminal activities and engineering depressions so you can consolidate power. You are on notice, criminals. The answer to your 1984 society is 1776. 1776 to you and the Anglo-American British Empire. 1776 to your tyranny. 1776 to your New World Order. We're going to let everybody know we got all the documents and all the proof, and it's now been testified in Congress, that you are engineering the depression, that you are the criminals, that you are the mob bosses, that you are organized crime. You aren't going to get away with what you just pulled. You just bit off something bigger than you can chew, criminals. Come out here and go ahead and turn state's evidence against your private system. Report on the other members of the private Federal Reserve, and some of you may not even make it to prison. Come out with your hands up, criminals. In the Fed, in the fraud, in the scam, in the private fractional reserve banking, in the New World Order, in the Fed, 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 in the Fed. I'm going to talk to the workers up there on the parapet, the ones smoking cigarettes and just jump back. You're with the American people, we know that, but understand, ask the workers inside. You're not in a federal government building. You're in a private Federal Reserve that uses that name as a fraud. That'd be like if my first name was Federal Reserve Jones. I'm still not the federal government. I'm not a federal government. I'm not a federal agency. But if I said my name was Federal Reserve, I could go out and pay off politicians and get them to allow me to get into power so I could issue the currency and credit, and then I could buy up the world. That's what these criminals have done. No one is above the law, and the private Federal Reserve sure as hell isn't either.
The Constitution above the law.
You're not above the law.
The Constitution and the people that the Constitution stand for are above you. You are not above the law, criminals. And for anybody here that didn't see it, Google Alan Greenspan says Fed above the law. You will see him say, we are above the law, above the Congress, above the president, above any court, above any law enforcement agency. They, on record, say they own us, and Kashkari and Paulson go in Congress and laugh at the congressman when the congressman say, you just took $5 trillion. It was supposed to be $800 billion. You're keeping it all for yourself. What are you doing? You lied, and they just laugh at them. They are raping this country. And when these police officers' families are going bankrupt in the Depression, that'll be here by next year. I want you to remember, these guys did it. We have the documents, Infowars.com. Remember, when you're losing everything you got, they're doing it. They created the Great Depression. They're engineering this. They are our mortal enemies. The private Federal Reserve are our mortal enemies. They are sworn enemies of the Republic and every free human being. They are part of a private, worldwide, offshore criminal network of money-changing criminals.
In the Fed! In the Fed! In the Fed! In the Fed!
You know, banking is big news right now. And all over local TV, national TV, CNN, Fox, they're showing news pieces with people praying at the banks and praying to Congress. Oh, please help me. I know you want to help me. No, the private banks want to implode the economy and rape these people financially. But we all call the local media, national media. Notice they're not here because they're owned by these people. They have a stake. Let me tell you something. Every time I'm watching a House or Senate hearing on the main TV news channels, they show Bernanke. They show Paulson, they show the other people, they show Kashkari. But as soon as they go to the congressman exposing the fraud that you can watch on C-SPAN, they cut away. And it's the same thing. If the mainstream corporate whore media won't show congressmen exposing their crimes, we shouldn't expect them to cover this. But that's why we have the alternative media. Put all the videos of this on YouTube, on Google. Put them on local access TV, because the word is getting out And the people know the Federal Reserve is a private criminal organization masquerading as a federal agency. So that is certainly wonderful, fabulous news. And again, Congressman Ron Paul has introduced legislation, and he has close to 70 sponsors, to abolish the private Federal Reserve. In the Fed! In the Fed!
In the Fed! In the Fed! In the Fed! In the Fed! In the Fed! In the Fed! In the Fed! In the Fed! In the Fed!
The Federal Reserve is a run-for-profit private organization. Congressman Ron Paul has close to 70 sponsors with a bill to abolish the private Federal Reserve. It is the private Federal Reserve that cut off liquidity and credit a year and a half ago that has organized the financial implosion. You see, big private banks need to have the economy fall so that everybody has prices drop so they can buy up the economy. This is a criminal operation being carried out by the private Federal Reserve. And we just had the local police representative say, yes, he knows it's private. Well, a lot of the American people don't know it's private, and a lot of the American people don't know that in Congress, it's on record that they just stole not $850 billion, but $5 trillion. And it's only November 22nd. They were given unlimited power in that bill, so it can't even be reviewed. That is tyranny. That is a fraud. We must abolish the private Federal Reserve to save our economy. It is the private Federal Reserve that is engineering the collapse of our economy, that terrorized the public and the Congress into granting them omnipotent power in the banker bailout bill. And since then, they baited and switched, as Congress has said, and have stolen the $5 trillion. And Fed Chairman of the private Fed system, Bernanke, said on record last week in AP and Reuters, you pull it up, that they will not tell Congress where $2 trillion of the $5 trillion went.
In the Fed! In the Fed! In the Fed! In the Fed!
Our founding fathers, many of our presidents fought against them. JFK tried to abolish them, and that was the last straw when he signed an executive order to start issuing U.S. notes. And when he did that, they killed him 45 years ago today. We've done the research. We've talked to their mistresses, their eyewitnesses, their lawyers. I've interviewed LBJ's lawyer. We've got all the eyewitnesses and E. Howard Hunt running the sniper team. Before he died, he did an interview with his son, and we now have the video, and we put it out on the web. The Dallas Police Department picked Hunt up as one of the tramps, but then was ordered by the Secret Service to let Hunt go. E. Howard Hunt, the guy that ran all those black ops, look it up. The police department arrested him, was ordered to release him before he died of cancer. He did a video interview on record that, yes, it was him, the Dallas Police Department basically grabbed. Yes, they ran the black op operation. Yes, they were here when they killed Kennedy 45 years ago today. And guess who met at Clint Murchison's house? Guess who met with Nixon and LBJ the night before in Dallas? Federal Reserve representatives. They killed Kennedy 45 years ago today. These are murdering criminals inside there. And we are here. We are here, ladies and gentlemen, to stand up against these individuals. We are here to let them know that we are not going along with their new world order. Because the private Federal Reserve isn't just here in the United States. It's all over the world under different names. Federal Bank of this, Federal Bank of that. They are not federal banks. They are private crime syndicate that took over in 1913 and is now orchestrating the depression that we're going into. Look into it. For everybody out there on the web watching this, understand, your life depends on exposing these criminals of the private Federal Reserve. In the Fed! In the Fed!